NHS and emergency workers who got tickets. They all went in 20 minutes. Tonight's concert was gratefully received.
Just to have the recognition, it does make a big, big difference for us. Definitely. It's like when they're clapping for the NHS as well. That was really, really good as well.
Is perhaps a distant memory. McCaslin says for him, it's a reminder that the NHS continues to make sacrifices.
We take it for granted. We're lucky to live in a country where we can take something like that for granted. It's my hug, basically, to anybody who we can give that hug to, because they've been looking after us, so, you know, we should give a bit back.
Other artists like Liam Gallagher have also staged free concerts to thank healthcare workers. And Astley says these initiatives should, if possible, continue.
Either to raise funds to throw back at the NHS or just to give free gigs to people who work in the NHS. I think it's not a bad idea to say, well, every tour that you do, why not do a gig for others? Do you know what I mean? And I do think the music community would definitely feel that. I think they'd be well up for that.
They're gonna give you up. They're gonna let you down.
Saturday in Manchester, he's putting his words into action with a second free gig for healthcare workers. Nina Nanar, News at 10 at Wembley.
What a great place to end. That's it. See you tomorrow. Good night. Thanks for watching.
Today, many places could see temperatures start to soar, especially later on. Heinz Soup sponsors ITV National.
A very good evening to you. Cloudy skies for many of us in the next few days, but some welcome sunshine for others. Turning things up a touch, and some misty nights to come as the week wears on. Some grey, gloomy mornings here and there. As for the next few hours, the rain slides its way across much of central southern Scotland, parts of Northern Ireland, quite breezy with some mist and some fog over the highest ground. Elsewhere, mostly dry, out of the breeze, some mist and low cloud forming come the small hours. And nowhere near as cold as it could be overnight, given the time of year. Certainly frost-free, mild feeling for many of us tomorrow morning, but very grey from the word go and quite gloomy across the south first thing, with the mist and low cloud here. And as we head through the day, that rain slides its way southwards through parts of Northern England and Wales. Quite blustery, dull and damp across those western locations, a little drier to the east of the Pennines. Either side of this, trying to cheer up a touch. Occasional sunshine, staying mild in the south, but a little chillier for Scotland and Northern Ireland. See you soon.
Heinz Soup sponsors ITV National Weather.
Shark attack in Australia. One father, 4 minutes after his resolution, was swimming near Perth when he was attacked. His wife paid tribute to him and praised the brave teenagers who helped to save other swimmers. Mark McQuillan has more.
After 2 days, the search has been called off. Helicopters and sonar were used to scour the ocean off Western Australia for the body of Paul Millichip, but all they found was a pair of goggles. The 57-year-old who grew up in Wilston before he went to Perth had been a kilometre to swim on Saturday morning when he was attacked by a shark. Teenagers who tried to help believe it may have been a 14-foot great white.
When the dinghies were there trying to get the body into the boat, they obviously couldn't because the shark kept going at it.
Paul's partner of 35 years was on the beach when the attack happened.
Came out of the blue. But it did happen, you just have to deal with it.
A veteran veteran of six Ironmans, Paul was a strong swimmer. He was a regular at the beach.
Rest in peace, Paul. What he enjoyed doing the most, which was exercising. Thank you very much.
More lives were potentially saved by four teenagers who got other swimmers out of the water.
A special mention to those young lads in the boat for what they did. It must have been an absolutely terrifying experience for them. So my heart goes out to them and I thank them for what they did.
Deadly shark attacks are extremely rare, but the numbers are slowly rising. Paul's death is the third in Australia this year.
Times have changed, and there's a lot more sharks around. Less fish for them to eat, so it's just an ongoing thing. You've just got to be careful.
The events at Port Beach were horrific and very, very sad. So our family is now grieving. A man has lost his life. It's a terribly sad situation for everyone involved.
I saw one right back by the tent driveway, but it was a small one. And once my dad gets up here and I know that he's at the cabin and everything, his place, I will grab my stuff and go out. And I want to take care of my bar stand today. I decided to walk down a trail that's kind of by where Sarah's stand is, and I jumped a grouse and I shot it, and I got it, and then didn't think when I went to get it, and I saw
here, but the one for the far stand and one for here if it was needed, but I don't think I need it this year. That should be ready for whenever I decide to sit there. Lightly snowing out.
Oh, one beer stand done.
Monitor to help keep the